Ooh, holy cow. Oh, that's bright. Come here. Oh, hey, Facebook. Okay. Mommy normally doesn't go live at this time, so we'll see who pops in. Holy cow, I got my glasses on, guys, so we are seeing a
take
lot.
Take them off.
A lot of light. I can't see if I take them off. Hey, as you guys are popping in, let me know where you're tuning in from. I'm going to fix this lighting. Stop. Show them your elf pajamas. Oh, I think Danielle says you're so cute. You're so cute.
Thank you.
Hi, Tennille. How are you? How's it going? Gonna give it a minute. I don't really go live at night, so this is very new for me. We are in our PJs. So here's
Austin.
Here's Landon and here's Austin behind me. Okay. They love your jammies, everybody. They love your jammies. Okay, get it.
I'm sliding down the chimney.
All right, they're going to go watch TV. All right. Go ahead. Austin, now. Now. Okay, let me get the kids.
Landon!
Can you get... Close
Landon.
The door. Close the door. All right, so I have like this terrible reflection. With these glasses, but I can't see. So I probably should have left my contacts in, and the lighting is like kind of crazy. So anyways, all right guys, as you're tuning in, tell me where you're tuning in from. Say hello. I know I normally go live during the day. Anita, what's up? Hi, Michael. Did you grab your wine? Everyone grab their wine, because Mama's drinking tonight. Mama's drinking, I'm wrapping presents. What are you guys doing? Drop me a comment below and let me know what you guys are doing. We're going to be talking about why you want to zig when they zag. And I will explain this in a minute. But and I've been giving this a lot of thought because I am asked all the time how I've been having like everything I do blessed. I'm very, very blessed. But out of all my businesses, they've been successful. And I want you to understand that I was somebody that thought I was a nobody. Okay, so I don't know if you can relate to that, but there was a time in my life where I felt like I had nothing to give, that I was not smart enough, that I was not good enough. I felt like that guy from Saturday Night Live that, what was his name? That, or her name, I don't know, that they look in the mirror and they're like, I'm not smart, or I'm smart enough, I'm good enough, and doggone it, somebody loves me, or something like that. Do you guys know what I'm talking about? Do you remember that? Or, like, I'm old, I know I'm 40, but do you guys remember Saturday Night Live? Was it Smalley or Smurly, or I don't know. Anyways, Anita, you're cleaning the house and getting ready for the holidays. Amen to you, lady. Let me tell you, I'm not hosting anything. Nothing. All right, so I'm going to just talk to you guys really quick. Yes, Michael, thank you. Stuart Smalley. Yes, Stuart Smalley. I loved Stuart Smalley. So funny. But, I mean, honestly, that's how my life was. Can you guys hear me okay? I feel like I have a total glare because of this light with these glasses. But, Eva, you got your hair chopped? Oh my gosh, I cannot wait to see it. You're beautiful no matter what, but I can't wait to see the do. Hey, what's up, Joe? How are you? All right, so my title, Be the Zig to Their Zag. This is how I have created over 7 figures in my businesses. 5 businesses I have had in my life. Now, one was a brick and mortar business, and it was a franchise, okay? Yes, you love your hair. I remember when I chopped my hair, girl. It felt so good. I can't wait to see it. So when I owned my franchise, what I did was I was 22 years old. I was sick of corporate America. I absolutely despised my boss, okay? And the reason I invested in a franchise, and yes, at such a young age, I actually had the money in my bank account for a franchise. I'm asked this all the time. I saved up money because I lived at home. I didn't go away to college, you guys. I had no desire to go to college, okay? And so I just went out in a real world and I just started working after high school. And all my friends were going to all these Ivy League top-notch universities, okay? So for me, I said, well, I'm going to go work in corporate America and I just want to make money. And so I did. And then I quickly realized corporate America was not the place for me, okay? Period. I don't know if any of you have been in corporate America, but if you've been in corporate America, drop me a poop emoji because that's what I think about freaking corporate America, okay? I walk in an office now. If I walk into an office to visit my husband or my friend, what have you, like I get a physical reaction because offices have this like scent to it. Like it smell, like, do you guys know what I'm talking about? Like there's a certain scent in an office and it's cold and it's the, I have no desire to be there. Okay. So went to the franchise. Now I said I wanted to open a franchise and people laughed at me. What did I do? I was the zig to the zag. They're like, what are you doing open a franchise? You're 22 years old. Like, who do you think you are? Kind of a thing. And I'm talking like family, guys. Like, not my parents. My parents always supported me. But uncles and cousins, like, they just thought it was funny, okay? Zig to the zag. When everyone was just doing the do, walking around like zombies, I decided at a young age, I don't want to walk around like a zombie, okay? I decided that I want to make something of my life. I wanted freedom. I wanted to get away from corporate America. And so what did I do? I purchased a franchise. Now, I thought a franchise was the answer to, sorry, I'm in my robe, by the way. I'm in my pajamas. You guys are seeing me in my robe. And it's kind of warm in here. Okay, so I had people laugh at me, and even though I had people laugh at me, do you think it stopped me in my tracks? No, because the pain of corporate America was so far worse than having people laugh at me and having thoughts in my mind of, what if this fails? What if I don't like this? This is a huge investment. What if, what if, what if? You guys, our entire life is based on what ifs, right? It's always going to be based on what ifs. And so I took the leap. I zigged to their zag. They stayed in misery. I purchased the franchise to get away from corporate America. Now, first couple years, I was young. I thought this is amazing. I own my own business. And then, of course, I learned I was there all the time. Do I have any traditional business owners here? Or do you know traditional business owners that are stressed to the max? If you do, give me like a hand raise here, okay? Because I will tell you right now, I wish I knew about network marketing when I was back in my 20s, because I absolutely, if I was educated the right way, would have jumped into network marketing and saved myself $750,000 in investing in franchises, okay? So what happened? Even though it was 8 years of feeling like I was in a prison pretty much for the first 5 years until things started running, I was able to back off of some hours. But I will tell you, you guys, it is so flipping stressful owning your own brick and mortar business. It is so stressful, okay? And so I sold them after 8 years. But guess what? We sold them for almost seven figures. And they were pretty much paid off. So at 32 years old, able to walk away with almost seven figures. Pretty cool, right? It was 8 years of hell to get to there, but yeah, I zigged to their zag. Now, that was my franchise. So here I am, I'm a stay-at-home mom, 32, 33 years old, had our first baby, and I was sitting there and I'm like, okay, this is great. I always wanted to be a stay-at-home mom, but you know what? I still have that entrepreneur spirit. So what did I do? here comes entering direct sales. It was the zig to the zag. Does this make sense, you guys? Are you guys understanding? I'm going to walk you through all this because I want to see more people zigging to other people zagging, because most people walk through life in misery, and I don't want that. And so this is what I mean. I entered direct sales. I found direct sales to be super annoying. Why? Because I was gone all the flipping time. I was gone at home parties, nights and weekends. I did not want to do it. Yes, I was making money, but money doesn't buy you happiness, okay? I was not happy. I was leaving my newborn child. I was leaving my husband. And so then what happened? Network marketing enters my life 5 years ago. Probably five and a half years ago now. And so I go into network marketing. And what do you think happened when I entered network marketing? Does anybody know? Like, does anybody want to guess what happened when I went into network marketing? When I was the zig to somebody else's zag? I mean, let's just take a guess. What usually typically happens from friends and family when you get started inside of network marketing? I'll give you a minute to comment, because I'm literally walking you through how I created well over seven figures in my businesses by this thing I'm going to be sharing with you. What happens when most people in network marketing get started? Anyone want to take a guess? I'll give it a minute. What do we normally get? What do we normally get when we enter network marketing? They discourage you. Yep. Sure, Anita, but what do we normally get? What normally stops us in our tracks in network marketing? Because, I don't know, family and friends think you're crazy? Absolutely, Danielle. People gasp? Yep. Rejection? Yep. They said you cray? Yep. What else do they say? The word no? Yep. Fear? Yep. Negativity? Yep. What else? You get the pyramid scheme, right? You're in the pyramid scheme. So here I am zigging to their zag. They're all like attorneys, accountants, nurse practitioners. I have friends that are doctors. And here I am in network marketing. Hello. So I went from a franchise owner to then direct sales to then network marketing. And I get from one of my best friends, you're in a pyramid scheme. Okay. But guess what? I zigged to their zag. I didn't let them hold me back because they did not approve. Because they didn't approve. They were laughing at me. They said I was part of a pyramid scheme. But what happened? Instead of quitting, I showed up in my business and learn the profession of network marketing, okay? I started studying, I started reading. I literally have thousands of hours of learning skill sets, okay? Not just working on personal development, you guys, because that's another zig to their zag, and I'm gonna get to that in a minute, but I learned the profession. I went to Facebook. I didn't do what everyone else was doing on Facebook. I was creating curiosity on Facebook. I was showing my life on Facebook. I was branding myself on Facebook when I didn't even know what the hell branding was, okay? So I was doing things different, and that's why I went to six figures in a year, okay? That's why I went to six figures in a year in that network marketing business, and in 22 months, I was making multiple six figures a year because I wasn't doing posts like everybody else. I was creating curiosity. I wasn't spamming, okay? So again, I know we're taught from a young age, follow the leader. It's different inside your network marketing company. Yes, you want to duplicate on the back end, but you really don't want to follow the leader on the front end. You want to be you. And this is why I now teach so strongly about branding your own personality, okay? You have to be you. So I spent thousands of hours learning skills from online marketing to now recently online marketing and branding, all this stuff, right? The past year, if you guys have been following me, you know I've built some pretty significant businesses, and I teach this. But what I'm talking about zigging and zagging with personal development is this. personal development, and this is really key, and I don't know if you guys will agree with this, and feel free to disagree with me. I agree to disagree anytime if you guys want to disagree. Because in network marketing, there's personal development. And trust me, I've had my fair share. I've had lunch with John Maxwell. Totally amazing man. Okay? Love him. I have been with Lisa Nichols. She's incredible. I mean, Robin Sharma, Eric Worre on several occasions, you guys. So here's the thing. I know there's Tony Robbins. I haven't met him, but there's personal development. We talk a lot about personal development on an entrepreneur journey, in an entrepreneur journey, and inside specifically network marketing, because we get so much rejection. But here's the thing. If you stay stuck in personal development mode, it's very difficult to get out and it's very difficult to take action. So I believe that there is an over, what's the word I want to use, you guys? There is, you can overly do personal development, okay? Because I was there, you guys, I was there. I was in personal development mode for a long time because I had a lot of fear in starting my fan page. I had a lot of fear in doing Facebook Live, and I kept working on my mindset, working on my mindset, working on my mindset, that then I felt like all I was doing was working on my mindset and I wasn't working on my business. Okay. If you guys can relate to this, drop me a one. Just let me know if you know what I mean. Like, you're constantly, you feel like you have some sort of confidence issue, or not like have strong belief in yourself, you guys, whatever it is, because I'm going to tell you, personal development is great. I don't want to say anything. I mean, I've done it, and believing in yourself is super important because that brings posture. But I also want to make a statement of, there is a thing I feel is too much personal development. Okay. So what did I do? I do some personal development, but I don't overly do it. So I zig to their zag. When most people were staying stuck in personal development, I was taking action. Okay. Then enter online marketing, branding, this whole fan page that I started in last June. Here we go. Another zig to their zag. Okay. I was watching everybody in this space showing up and starting doing Facebook Live. Facebook Live was very, very new, okay? And I was doing the whole comparison game. Comparing yourself to somebody else is deadly for your business. I will tell you this right now. It's deadly. And here's what I mean. I wasn't showing up and doing Facebook Live, even though I knew Facebook Live was crucial to grow my brand and my business, because there were times where I didn't have makeup on, which is pretty much all the time. I'm a stay-at-home mom. Or I was nervous that the dog was going to bark. Rest in peace, Harley. But the dog was going to bark when I was doing a Facebook Live. Or, I mean, I'm a mom. How many of you are parents? Like, you're crazy freaking parents out there. If you're a parent, drop me any emoji. Drop me an emoji. Drop me a crazy face emoji, because you know what the heck I'm talking about. You like don't have time to completely write out your Facebook Live. Like, you know, I was literally like, what am I going to talk about? I was preparing it. I was like, wait a second, what if the kids bust in? Or if I had to go drop them off at school, guess what? I had to do it for my freaking car. You guys, who the hell cares? So once I dropped and unmasked all of the nonsense that was in my own head, because you guys, it is in our own heads, I finally decided that I was not going to care if I wore makeup, that I was not going to care if I screwed up on my Facebook Live, that I didn't care if I did it from the parking lot of Starbucks. I had to be me, and I had to show people it was okay. And so again, I started creating my own personality brand. I started consistently showing up and creating value. See, I was always giving value, and value and content and all these words, branding. I mean, you know, hello, enter 2017, right? I mean, we hear about this all the time. But 5 years ago, I was doing it and didn't even realize I was doing it, okay? Now I see people posting pictures about maybe every other picture is like a picture of their shake or a picture of their oil or a picture of their whatever. And they're branding their company and they're branding their business. They're not necessarily branding them. You're tired? Okay, let me just finish and we'll go to bed. I promise you. You guys, Landon's so awesome. Like, the kid literally comes to me and says he's tired. Allison, what's up, girl? Julie, thank you for pushing me to go live. I totally should have been. Oh, Allison, I love you. You guys need to follow Allison because she has an amazing mompreneur page and always offers amazing, amazing value. So I love you, girl. Look her up. Okay. I'm still going on with my zig to the zag. So here we go. Listen, and I have my notes here. That was another thing. What if I have notes? Who cares if you have notes? People are so nervous about Facebook Live. I right now have students in my group coaching program, and somebody in my private group for my group coaching students said yesterday, I hate Facebook Live. And we all rushed to her, like, and really what it comes down to it is that it just takes a while to get comfortable. But you guys, it's like anything in life. It's a little weird at first, I'm not gonna lie, but it's okay to screw up. It's okay to have notes. The thing is, if you say these things like I hate, your words become your reality. Like, we all know that. But here's the thing. When you say that, you are putting yourself in this negative space, and not just that, you're making it about you and not about the person you're supposed to shine your light for, right? Not the person you're supposed to meant to impact that day. If you impact one soul one day, guess what? That's the most amazing thing ever. So guess what? I had to push myself out of the way, and when everybody else was scared to do Facebook Live, I had to zig to their zag. I had to go first. Do you guys understand this? Is this making sense, you guys? If it is, show me some love. Drop me some hearts down below. Okay. Now, I want to talk about changing companies. So if you follow me, you know I had a little bit of an issue pop up with my last company. Let's just say they didn't support me being an online entrepreneur. Let's just leave it at that. So I went through a lot of heartache. I went through sadness and I went through pain. But guess what? It wasn't meant to be. So I followed my gut. I followed my intuition and I zigged when most people would zag. What does that mean? I didn't come at it from this scarcity mindset of, oh, and here we go. Here's the kids are screaming. The kids are screaming. I knew this wouldn't last long, you guys. I didn't come at it from the scarcity mindset of I'm losing multiple six-figure income. I came at it that I will have abundance somewhere else and I will make sure of it. I created the vision. I created that vision, and most people think I'm crazy for walking away. I didn't even sell the position, you guys. It was almost a seven-figure position. I did not sell. Why? Because I have integrity. I didn't feel right leaving that position in anyone else's hands, okay? So I left. I zigged to their zag, and guess what? I am so much happier than I've ever been. So everything could be a blessing in disguise, and I share that because sometimes we get caught. I'll give you an example. I had someone reach out to me, and I did this launch video with my new business a couple weeks ago, okay? And she reached out to me privately, and she said, how did you know? Like, what was it? How did you know your last company wasn't for you? And I'm like, what do you mean? I'm like, first of all, you have to ask yourself, are you happy? Are you happy with what you're doing day in and day out? And if you're staying in a company because your sister's part of the company or your family member's part of the company, or you have a large team and you don't know how to leave them, you're there for the wrong reason. If you are not happy, if your soul is not set on fire, then you are staying for the wrong reasons. You are staying because it's convenient for them, not for you. You're making it about others. You're not making it about yourself. And sometimes when it comes to our happiness, you guys, we have to think about ourselves. Because if we are not 100% fulfilled, and I asked her, do you feel fulfilled? And she said, no. And I said, but you're staying because so-and-so is in your company. Yes. It's for the wrong reasons, you guys. You have to zig to other people's zag. Because you will live in misery. A year from now, she will kick herself in the ass if she is still with that company and unhappy. Does that make sense? Cool. Okay. So, changing companies. Yes, it was difficult, but needed to happen. It was the best decision ever. Here we go. Another one. Zig to their zag. If I see one more person post about the freaking Facebook algorithm, I think I might puke. And yesterday, I speak my mind. Like, that is how I built my brand. When people say why, I say why not. I have literally spoken my mind through my, there's nothing that I can hide, or people that know me know, like, I'm a no fluff person. And so when I was seeing all of these people who were probably told by their upline or maybe even their network marketing company, I don't even know, because there was a lot of network marketers talking about freaking algorithms. It was literally a copy and paste post, a copy and freaking paste post that I was like watching this. I mean, it kept showing up in my feed and I'm like, what the hell is this? The point was they were trying to get people to drop a GIF or to drop a comment about the freaking algorithm. Like, who the hell cares? Who cares? If you are busy building your brand, if you're busy making an impact, if you're busy going out there and creating some sort of value to help people to change their freaking life, you're not gonna be putting a BS post out there about the freaking algorithm to just try and get followers. So guess what? I put a post out there yesterday saying the exact same thing, because I zig to their freaking zag. I don't want to be like everybody else. There's no need for me to be like everybody else, because we are our own unique DNA, you guys, okay? So guess what? That was my whole purpose for showing up tonight in my pajamas. My boys are screaming and I have my wine and I got my friends on. I'm super excited. I love you guys. But I just wanted to put my story out there and talk about really zigging to other people's zag. Don't follow the leader, freaking be the leader. Like, show up day in and day out, do your own thing. Please don't copy and paste posts, because there's nothing more annoying. If you are in network marketing, please stop posting a picture of your product every single day and show up and teach somebody something. I don't really care what the heck it is. Just teach them something and make an impact for one person. You know what I'm saying? Like, that is how people are like, how did you gain so many followers? I even have a mentor and she's amazing. And she's like, how did you gain this many followers that fast? You guys, honestly, there's no magic. I'm not even running traffic to anything right now. I have like zero ads running, like zero. Yes, on my fan page, I've learned, like, hello, Facebook priority, you got to run traffic to certain stuff. I mean, this is why I have a fan page. But now, because I spent the time paying upfront for traffic and my likes ad campaigns and things like that, I get amazing organic reach. I don't have to spend the money anymore, which is really, really cool. So this is what I'm saying. Like, show up, be you. I can't really explain about how I gained the following so fast. I think it was really just because I showed up consistently. You guys, that's it. Let me put my wine down. It's really about consistency and not just giving value, but being bold, being brave, being vulnerable, yes, showing up with integrity, being impactful, sharing your story. It's very important to share your story. But really, on a consistent basis, I have had my priority be my fan page. Some people want to do personal page, which is fine, but you can't really leverage a personal page like you can leverage a fan page. And that's why I teach so much about around building up your brand on your fan page as well as your personal page, you guys. But I'm going to tell you, Mark Z doesn't like us doing business on our personal page. So you really, really, really have to be careful, you guys, okay? So listen, I'm going to go before these kids kill each other. Landon has chocolate all over his mouth. I have no idea how. They're obviously in the pantry. And my husband's on his way home with a pizza because I'm starving. So anyways, I love you guys. Thank you so much for hanging with me tonight. I've never done a night Facebook Live like this before on my fan page, so it was really kind of cool. I wish everyone a very, very, very Merry Christmas if you're celebrating Christmas. And I will see all of you real soon. Okay. Bye, guys. Bye, Allison. And bye. Hey, Tracy. I didn't even say hi to you. Natalie. I posted that. I'm sorry. I'm looking. Natalie, you know what? Just delete it, girl. Just delete it. It's okay. But you know what? Natalie, I love you for being honest that you posted the crazy algorithm junk. Embarrassing. You know what? You owned it. Just go delete it, girl. But yes, be unique. Be unique. Hey, Sarah, what's up? All right, if you guys are on the replay, put hashtag replay, and I will make sure to give you a shout out. And also, I have my new how to build your own personality brand. If you guys want to learn more about branding, I have my new freebie coming out. Just drop brand in the comments, and I'll make sure to get you that, okay? Sorry for the glare, guys. Like, this is crazy with these glasses. I just can't do that with the Diva Light. But all right, everyone, have a good night. Bye.